there's one thing we do know. The line between victim and attacker ain't as clear as you might think.
I suppose that's one lesson we can take away from this case.
I cut off the leg before the poison spread. By spring, flowers will grow from the stump.
Something already.
Your tongue-tied silence speaks volumes. I knew you were the culprit. Wait just a minute. None of that is possible. Shuichi was with me the whole time we were on lookout. When are you suggesting Shuichi killed Rantaro?
Were you really together the whole time?
Huh? What do you mean?
I'm asking if you two were on lookout together the whole time.
Well, I guess we weren't together the whole time.
So that's when Shuichi went to kill Rantaro!
No! Shuichi wouldn't kill anyone!
Don't become emotional. We must seek the truth in a calm and...
No. I don't believe that's Shuichi.
Here. I'm saying it with conviction.
The murder weapon. He couldn't have thrown the ball.
Didn't ring until after Shuichi returned to the classroom. It only rang after Rantaro moved the hidden door, which means he was still alive. If Shuichi was with me when the alarm went off, then that means he's not the culprit.
By the way, I want to confirm one thing with you, Kaede. Who set the security sensor on the bookcase? It was Shuichi, right?
Yeah, Shuichi was the one who set up the security sensor. What about it?
Did you actually check for yourself if the sensor was set on the bookcase, Kaede?
No, I didn't check.
Did it ever occur to you that Shuichi could have lied about setting the sensor?
A lie?
Shuichi pretended to place the sensor on the hidden bookcase door. But in actuality, he was holding it the whole time. And when he met up with you, he secretly triggered the sensor to make the security alarm go off.
That would cause Kaede to assume that someone had moved the bookcase.
I see, sneaky little fucker!
I'm not buying it. Not buying it.
The security sensor was armed, but the moving bookcase isn't what triggered it. As it turns out, Shuichi had it the whole time.
The sound Kaede heard came from the sensor when Shuichi secretly moved it. In order to trigger the alarm.
What?
So when Kaede heard the sensor go off, she figured someone had tried to move the bookcase.
Only an idiot can make that mistake.
No. It was the sensor. Because the sensor went off.
The security sensor was armed, but the moving bookcase isn't what...
Why is it being so
As it turns out, Shuichi had it the whole time.
The sound Kaede heard came from the sensor when Shuichi secretly...
Well, I'm probably gonna
die. The security sensor was armed, but the moving bookcase isn't what triggered it. As it turns out, Shuichi had it the whole time.
The sound Kaede heard came from the sensor when Shuichi secretly moved it.
Not that.
In order to trigger the alarm.
So when Kaede heard the sensor go off, she figured someone had tried to move the bookcase.
Only an idiot can make that mistake. The security sensor was armed, but the moving bookcase isn't what triggered it.
Dude,
as it turns out, Shuichi had it the whole time.
The sound Kaede heard came from the sensor when Shuichi secretly moved it.
How do I make this speed up?
In order to trigger the alarm.
So when Kaede heard the sensor go off,
I'm not going to.
She figured someone had tried to move the bookcase.
Only an idiot can make that mistake.
Now I'm running out of time.
The security sensor was armed, but the moving bookcase isn't what triggered it.
Yes, there we go. Finally, I was trying to do that like 3 times ago.
Wait a minute. This is weird. If the security sensor wasn't placed, then...
Oh yeah, cool. Yeah, I didn't buy it.
We wouldn't have been able to take that picture. We were only able to get it because the sensor was triggered by the hidden door.
Oh, that? Easy to explain. Well, you see... I guess you're right. Sorry, I didn't think that far ahead.
You're giving up that easily?
Whatevs. I made a mistake. Big deal.
You speak as if you knew that from the start. Even I was taken in.
So you see? Shuichi can't be the culprit.
Now wait just a minute. The security sensor had a power supply, so what if it went like this? The security sensor was set up on the bookshelf, and Shuichi had its receiver. However, Shuichi turned the receiver off. That would get you a picture, but no alarm when Rentaro moved the bookcase. Then, when Shuichi says he's gonna check the basement, he actually goes to the library. And thanks to the 30-second interval, he's got time to go in after Rentaro.
He could have collected the sensor from the hidden bookcase after killing Rentaro.
This is really sketchy. How would Shuichi know that Rentaro... So, here's the thing that I'm not getting. They both saw everyone going to the basement with Rentaro. How would not only Shuichi plan this so far ahead, but know that Rentaro was not going to go to the basement and was actually going to go to the library? That's what I'm wondering. I have literally... If this isn't Shuichi, and it wasn't Gonta, because I overlooked the moving door, I have less than no idea who this is. Ah.
see. Then he caused the receiver to go off in front of Kaede to trick her. It's certainly plausible, considering that Shuichi knew about the intervals.
Yeah. How needlessly complicated. But I guess it's not impossible. Then, Shuichi really is the culprit?
So the ultimate detective is the killer. What a plot twist!
Wait! Why do you guys think he's the culprit? Shuichi, please say something. Why aren't you saying anything?
Shuichi, what's wrong? You're not culprit, are you?
Hey, you gonna say anything? We'll all vote for you if you don't.
Are you okay with being the culprit? Are you ready to turn yourself in?
No, don't. What? I don't wanna. Dude, if it's Shuichi, I don't wanna fucking go around. Not sure, this is making this so needlessly complicated because I need to play as a character who wants to fuck the culprit. Thank you muchly.
Let's go over the case one more time.
The security sensor was placed on the movie bookcase. Shuichi also had the receiver.
But he had it turned off.
Yes.
And so when Rantaro moved the bookcase, a picture was taken without the alarm sound.
Then taking advantage of the camera's interval timer.
Shuichi hid in the library and murdered the shit out of Rantaro!
And then he grabbed the security sensor from the bookcase and returned to the lookout spot. Afterwards, he set off the receiver in front of Kaede on purpose to make her think the murder had just happened. Praise be to Atua! We've solved this case!
Let's go over the case one more time.
The security sensor was placed on the moving bookcase. Shuichi also got the receiver.
I'll turn this lie into the truth. Sorry, you guys. I forgot to tell you something important.
Oh my god, this is such an obvious lie. I don't like this. Oh my god. I actually don't like this. I don't think it's a bad game mechanic. I just don't like it.
Forgot?
To tell you the truth, it was me. I had the receiver.
Huh?
So that's why there's no way Shuichi could have turned off the receiver.
If that is true, then the entire premise of the argument thus far is wrong.
Is this true, Kaede?
Of course! Come on, would I lie to you guys?
That only screw yourself over. If we mess up, you're dead too, you know.
Or perhaps you wanted to cover for Shuichi, even at the cost of your life. Huh? I cannot imagine why anyone would risk their life to lie on another's behalf.
Words from a true heartless robot. Emotions are only for meatbags.
That is a harmful stereotype.
I can produce heartfelt remarks through calculations.
Kibo reminds me of people in Aaron's server.
Shuichi are pretty buddy-buddy with each other, so I wouldn't doubt that. Plus, the way Kaede just acted right now, I'm pretty sure she lied. A talented liar like me can spot other people's lies easily. Well, what do you guys think? To believe or not to believe Kaede?
I do want to believe Kaede, but Shuichi does seem pretty suspicious. Strangely quiet for a while now.
Shut up. Oh my god, this
I agree.
Dumbass degenerate male trope is so, like, just annoying. I'm like, some of these characters are really good, and some of them aren't.
Shuichi is the only person.
Tenko is by
suspicious.
Far my least favorite. I think Angie's a little better. Mackie, I have no onion on.
We all agree that Puichi did it?
No, I still think it is too soon to determine the culprit.
Kibo isn't bad per se.
I agree. I sort of can't believe that Shuichi is the culprit.
Yeah, this ain't right.
I agree. But I don't know if Atua agrees. Cause right now it's his nap time.
This is quite troublesome. It seems our opinions are on opposite ends.
How are we supposed to decide? We're split, right down middle.
Hold on!
Split? Did you just say split? You did! I heard it! I heard it with my belly button microphone!
So wait, your ears don't do anything?
The Ultimate Academy is proud to present its very own more phenomenal trial grounds!
More phenomenal trial grounds?
The trial grounds are gonna morph? Seriously? I totally wanna see that!
This is actually seeming really fucking complicated. I have no idea what this is already.
You hid what you knew about the camera intervals, Shuichi.
Unlike Shuichi, I actually have an airtight alibi.
She and Kaede weren't together the whole time, were they?
If Shuichi had the receiver, it could have been disguised.
But that's Kaede's lie, isn't it?
You hid what you knew about the camera intervals, Shuichi.
Kibo!
Kaede is the one who actually had the receiver.
Unlike Shuichi, I actually have an airtight alibi.
Shuichi and Kaede went together the whole time, were they?
Hirumi!
Goddamn.
Both of them were together when the receiver went off.
If Shuichi had the receiver, it could have been disguised.
But that's Kaede's lie, isn't it?
You hid what you knew about the camera. You hid what you knew about the camera intervals, Shuichi.
Unlike Shuichi, I actually have an...
I'll do it! We'll know whether or not it's a lie when we talk this through.
What?
Shuichi and Kaede weren't together the whole time, were they?
If Shuichi had the receiver, it could have been disguised.
But that's Kaede's lie, isn't it?
This keyboard is so fucking finicky, it's so annoying.
You hid what you knew about the camera intervals, Shuichi.
Gota!
But you silent about intervals, too.
Unlike Shuichi, I actually have an Akibo!
Kaede is the one who actually had the receiver.
Shuichi and Kaede went together the whole time, were they?
Hirumi!
Both of them were together when the receiver went off.
If Shuichi had the receiver, it could have...
Kibo!
Kaede is the one who actually had the receiver.
But that's Kaede's lie, isn't it?
I'll do it! We'll know whether or not it's a lie when we talk this through.
Oh my god.
I actually have an airtight alibi.
You hid what you knew about the camera intervals.
Gota!
But you silent about intervals, too.
Unlike Shuichi, I actually have an airtight alibi.
Shuichi and Kaede went together the whole time, were they?
Hirumi!
Both of them were together when the receiver went off.
If Shuichi had the receiver...
Kibo!
Kaede is the one who actually had the receiver.
Kaede's lie, isn't it?
Kaito!
Kaede backed up Shuichi's alibi, didn't she?
What? What'd I do wrong there? I tried both of them. I had everything according to plan. And then I tried the one that didn't work the other time, and it fucking failed on me. What the shit? I hate this. I actually hate this.
Is there nothing else I can do? We won't give up!
Don't be mean, Larvae.
You hid what you knew about the camera intervals, Shuichi.
What the fuck?
Unlike Shuichi, I actually have an airtight alibi.
Kibo!
Kaede is the one who actually had the receiver.
No.
Shuichi and Kaede went together the whole time, were they?
Hirumi!
Both of them were together when the receiver went off.
If Shuichi had the receiver, it could have been disguised.
But that's Kaede's lie, isn't it?
Kaito!
Kaede backed up Shuichi's alibi, didn't she?
You hid what you knew about the camera engine.
I just... this keyboard, it, like, it's finicky because when I hit the fucking key, it doesn't always go.
You hid what you knew about the camera intervals, Shuichi.
Gota.
But you silent about intervals, too.
Interval...
Unlike Shuichi, I am Kibo.
Kaede is the one who actually had the receiver.
Shuichi and Kaede went together the whole time, weren't they?
Hirumi!
Both of them were together when the receiver went off.
If Shuichi had the receiver...
Kibo!
Kaede is the one who actually had the receiver.
But that's Kaede's lie.
I'll do it! We'll know whether or not it's a lie when we talk this through. Unlike Shuichi, I actually have an airtight alibi.
So it's alibi.
You hid what you knew about the camera intervals, Shuichi.
Gota.
But you silent about intervals, too.
Unlike Shuichi, I actually have an airtight alibi. Kaito!
Kaede backed up Shuichi's alibi, didn't she?
Shuichi and Kaede...
Hirumi!
Both of them were together when the receiver went off.
If Shuichi...
Kibo!
Kaede is the one who actually had the receiver.
I'll do it. We'll know whether or not it's a lie.
Oh my god, that took so long. What is this? What the fuck, D? A? Ow! 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 Oh my god, that actually hurts so much. My wrist.
Everyone, you have to believe me. Shuichi is not the culprit. If we vote for Shuichi, we'll be making the wrong choice. And if that happens, everyone will be executed. I definitely won't let that happen, even if it costs me my life.
Kaede.
Yeah, it's just like Kaede said. Shuichi ain't the culprit.
Gonta believe in Shuichi too. Gentlemen always believe in friends.
Well, if Shuichi's not our culprit, then who is?
We've already exhausted all possible avenues of discussion.
Ryoma was alone.
There has to be something else we can discuss. We just got... Right, Shuichi?
Huh?
Shuichi, even though you're not the culprit, you've been quiet for a while. It's because you realized something, huh? You're scared to reveal the truth. I thought so. Shuichi, answer me this. What kind of truth did you realize? Don't be scared to say it. Not just for me, but for everyone else. Please, face the truth.
The picture.
Picture?
Picture from the camera aimed at the hidden door just before the murder. I always thought it was suspicious, the way Rantaro was acting.
What's suspicious?
If you look at the picture, it looks like Rantaro is trying to remove the camera, but that must mean he noticed the camera we set up.
That's true. But when did he notice that?
I believe it was when the camera took its first picture. This picture was taken when Rantaro moved the bookcase. At that moment, something made him notice the camera. So he tried to remove it. That's when the bookcase closed.
No, there's no way that's when the bookcase closed. Logically, because that's when everyone came in, and Rantaro right here is still alive. The bookcase was closing when we came in, which means that whoever the murderer was... Was the murderer Angie? Angie was in the hallway praying to Atua. So she could have came in and killed Rantaro. What an odd twist.
The sensor was triggered, and that's when this picture was taken.
If that is the case, we must find a reason why he noticed the camera.
You're confusing everyone! Except me, of course. Just get the...
I've been contemplating what it could be. Why did he notice the camera? And the answer is in this picture.
I get it.
The camera didn't have a flash.
Because of the flash, right?
Yes, the flash.
Yes, the flash went off when the hidden door camera took a picture. Rantaro noticed the camera's flash.
Oh yeah, we made them silent, but we didn't get rid of the flash.
But how can you tell the flash went off?
Well, if you compare it to the other pictures that we have. Remember the pictures that were taken when I took down the cameras? This is the picture taken when I removed the front camera. This is the picture from when I removed the rear camera. And this is the picture of Rantaro.
Whoa! The brightness is totally different!
Same room, circumstance, and camera. And yet, there is a disparity in brightness. Because only the camera aimed at the hidden door had the flash turned on.
Well, this was an omitted detail. When the fuck did this come in?
What was the purpose of leaving the flash on? Especially since it was meant to be hidden. A mistake, maybe?
It's no mistake. There was an objective here. That camera was placed for another reason.
Mia was the killer. What? What? No. So, hey, hold up. Maybe I'm jumping to conclusions real quick. But from what I can gather, Miu is the killer. Because she set the lights off so that Rantaro would notice it. And then she would take the advantage of Rantaro's backside. That sounded really lewd. And kill him with the ball, and then walk in with everyone else. That's a bit of a stretch. It feels like it. I don't really buy that, but that might be the truth.
Another reason, huh?
What?
I get it!
Flash was used to lure whoever moved the bookcase to the camera. So when the flash went off, they would have noticed the camera right away.
Wait, this is also really, really dumb. Because there's no way the interval between Rantaro opening the bookcase and him noticing the camera flash and just walking to the camera flash was fucking 30 seconds. There are some major flaws in this. Oh my god.
And that's exactly what happened. Rantaro moved the bookcase.
You could do that in like 20 at most, because you would open the bookcase. That would take 5 seconds from the position Rantaro was in. Notice the flash. And then even walking really slowly, it would probably take like 15 seconds to get to this point.
But the culprit didn't expect the camera to take another picture when the door closed.
Heyday?
What is it?
Is something wrong? You've been acting kind of strange.
Strange?
Your last few remarks carry more conviction than before.
Do you know who the culprit is?
Yep, I know. I've known for a long time.
It's Mew.
Hmm? Long time?
Because there was only one person able to set the flash on the camera. Isn't that right, Shuichi? The culprit of this incident is...
Why not move over one? What? What? Who? I don't know. What? Who could have? Ryoma? Hold on. Let's show the question. Who killed? Thank you for the question. I didn't know that. Oh my god. Fuck you. Who? I don't know. I sure as fuck don't know who did this. I'm dead. Who could have? So it's not Mew. No, it's not Mew.
No way!
Right, Shuichi?
Huh?
Shuichi, even it's because you're scared to... I thought so. Shuichi, answer me this. Don't be scared to say it. Please.
The picture.
Picture?
Picture from the camera. And the... I always thought it was suspicious, the way Rantaro was acting.
Hmm? What's suspicious?
If you look at the picture, but that must mean he noticed the camera we set up.
That's true. But when did he notice that?
I believe it was when the camera took its first picture.
This picture was taken when Rantaro moved the bookcase. At that moment, something made him notice the camera. So he tried to remove it. That's when the sensor was triggered and...
If that is the case, we must find the reason why he noticed the camera.
You're confusing everyone!
I've been contemplating what it could be. And the answer is...
I get it!
Because of the flash, right?
Yes. The flash went off. Rantaro noticed the cat.
But how can you tell the flash went off?
Well, if you compare it to... Remember the pictures that were taken? This is the picture taken. This is the picture from when I removed the rear camera. And this.
Whoa! The brightness!
Same room, circumstance. Because only the camera aimed at the hidden door had the flash turned on.
What was the purpose of leaving the flash on? Especially since it was meant to be hidden. Mistake, maybe?
It's no mistake. That camera is placed...
Another reason, huh?
I get it!
The flash was used to lure whoever moved the bookcase to the camera. So when the flash went... And that's exactly... Rantaro moved the bookcase, noticed the flash, and then walked over to the camera. But the culprit didn't expect the camera to take another picture when the door closed.
Hey, Kaede?
What is it?
Is something wrong? You've been acting...
Strange?
Your last few remarks...
Do you know who the culprit is?
Yep, I know. I've known for a long time.
Hmm? Long time?
Because there was only one person able to set the flash on the camera. Isn't that right, Shuichi? The culprit of this incident is...
I have no idea who it is. I don't. I really don't. I have literally no fucking idea who this could be. I feel like I've exhausted every possibility. Who set up the camera in the library? Me.
As far as it goes, I couldn't do it. I couldn't get to the mastermind. I'm sorry, everyone. I'm sorry, Rantaro. I'm sorry, Shuichi. You stayed silent this whole time because you realized it already, right? But you can't do that. It may be the end of me, but I want my wish to. I'm giving it to you, Shuichi. From now on, you're going to carry on my wish. You're going to protect everyone.
Kaede, I know what you want me to do. That's so cool. It's cool, but... I understand. I'll Kaede is the culprit.
What? I'm sorry, what?
Huh? Kaede did it?
Wait! That's not possible! Right, Kaede? Kaede? Wait! Did she really... Just kidding!
Just kidding?
Huh? Did you guys really think I'm the culprit? Shh, come on, When Rantaro was murdered, I was in the classroom with Shuichi, remember? After that, we went to the library, and that's the first time I even saw his body. Plus, I never met up with Rantaro. I never had a chance to kill him.
Yes. No way Kaede could be culprit.
Jeez, of course not. Do you think I'm even strong enough to throw that shot? My hands are only strong enough to play piano.
Then accusing you of being the culprit is...
Yep, it's wrong. Shuichi's just joking around. He wanted to lighten up the mood.
Right, Shuichi? No matter how you look at it, I couldn't have killed Rantaro with that shot.
No, I'm not joking around. Kaede definitely killed Rantaro.
What?
Seems as though Shuichi is serious after all.
Wait.
Of course I am.
Why don't you tell me then? How did I kill Rantaro with that shot?
Yeah, how? You and Kaede were together the whole time, weren't you?
How did Kaede? I was Kaede. What the fuck?
Have an alibi. When Rantaro was killed, I was in the classroom standing watch with Shuichi.
Kaede never saw Rantaro.
Fuck you.
How'd she kill him?
It's important to establish where the culprit used the shot. We know that it was in the library.
That's wrong!
Kaede didn't use the shot put ball at the scene of the crime. She used it at the first floor classroom, where we were keeping watch.
Hold on. How could she have hit Rantaro with a shot from a different floor?
This is dumb. This is really dumb.
She rolled the shot from the first floor classroom and hit Rantaro. I am skeptical that she could perform such a feat of accuracy.
It was a magic shot football? That's not possible.
It is possible. If you do it at the right spot in the classroom, it will reach the library.
So it seems you already know about that.
Because I was Kaede. There is no human on Earth who has figured out this trial, first try, like during the investigation. I don't believe it.
If you were to roll the shot in there, it would reach the library.
Did that do something? I thought it was just like Joker. Like a Joker card. It just takes away points or is a distraction. Oh my god, does this game have hidden Monokumas? How? Does that mean I've been missing hidden Monokumas?
Shot that fell from the vent. How did it strike Rantaro's head from that distance?
Yeah, that's impossible.
It's not like it started rolling on its own.
What are you doing?
On the Rantaro's head.
Maybe the shot was on the floor, and Rantaro tripped over it, causing him to hit his head on the bookcase.
What the?
Shot hit his head. Then he walked a few steps before he finally dropped dead.
Hey, Shuichi. Don't lose sight of the truth.
Nope. I'm really confused now.
The shot that fell from the vent. How did it strike Rantaro's head from that distance?
Yeah, that's impossible.
It's not like it started rolling on that
mountain. Oh my god. Move. Oh my fucking god, I'm gonna kill someone.
Maybe the shot was on the floor. And Rantaro tripped over it, causing him to hit his head on the bookcase.
The shot that fell from the vent. How did it strike Rantaro's head from that distance?
Yeah, that's impossible!
It's not like it started rolling.
Okay.
I agree.
It's just like Ryoma said. The shot rolled along the top of the bookcase and fell on Rantaro's head.
This is the biggest bullshit I've ever seen in a fucking DR game.
On top of the bookcases to direct the path of the shot.
The shot's path was directed by books? How would that even work?
Some of these murders are planned so far ahead. This is like inhumane.
It would be easier to explain with a floor plan of the library.
Clue.
Please, Mio.
Oh, want him that badly, huh? Fine. But now you owe me one. Voila! Feast your eyes on these babies.
Okay. First of all, that's not how the top of the bookcase looked. It's just not. Second of all, how did she roll the ball fucking at a precise angle so that it just wouldn't go flying down? They weren't stacked like stairs. I swear they weren't.
I see. The shot rolled on top of these books, eh?
Yes. I'm sure of it. The shot was rolled into the classroom vent and came out in the library. If the vent was open, the shot would have maintained momentum. And you did that, right, Kaede? We made sure the vent was open.
Impressive. You have a really good memory, Shuichi.
When the shot came through, the stacked books made a change direction. It then rolled down the path made by books. The books were stacked in rows so that the shot wouldn't fall off.
I swear to God that last part didn't exist. With the ramp.
The books blocked the shot from view. Then, when the ball was directly above Rantaro, it changed direction.
Also, the probability of that hitting his head is like zilch. Like, it literally could have hit his back and he would have just sustained a back injury. He wouldn't have died.
Rolled along the groove of the open books. On top of his head.
I think there's genuine flaws in this that they overlooked to make sure that it would just be an interesting twist. Because, okay, first of all, the door was closing when we came in. Okay, there's like three things I can think of that make this illogical to me. One, there's no way the time between Rantaro noticing the flash and him going to it was 30 seconds. That's just illogical. Second, this would mean that Rantaro died while Shuichi was gone, which means that Shuichi would have... This is wrong. There had to have been, like, a minute, at least. This is just plain wrong. If everything had gone according to plan for Kaede, the door would have been long closed by the time Rantaro died. There's no possible way that the door was closing when Rantaro died, because Shuichi was still downstairs. Or he was coming upstairs.
And it was the camera flash that lured him to that exact spot.
A setup that complicated is almost like a Rube Goldberg machine.
Heard her, she said she mentioned she likes food, Goldberg machines.
Well, it would be.
Wait, even with the Rube, whatever setup, when did she roll the ball into the duct?
That's right! Wasn't Shuichi with Kaede in the classroom?
That's it! The moment we ran out of the classroom.
That makes a little bit more sense, but the noticing part is still a major flaw.
sensor went off, I ran out first. And then Kaede followed. But just before she left...
There's flaws in this. The noticing part is the most prominent.
I'm right.
Of course, the ultimate detective would remember all that.
Your words and that smile. Is this your admission of guilt?
Hold on! Don't just jump to conclusions! I've still got a lot of questions!
That's weird. Why do you sound so desperate?
There's nothing weird about it. There's just no way I can believe someone like Kaede would be the culprit.
Yeah, don't not believe it either.
What?
Don't worry, Kaede. I'll clear your name. I refuse to believe that Kaede is the culprit. I still have my doubts. Doubts about the noise, of course. The library should have been warned, right?
Nope. No. Let me fucking move.
If that shot was rolling through the vents, it would have made a ton of noise.
No, 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 no. Stop. Oh my fucking god.
Rentaro would have heard.
Some noise ain't a big deal.
Of course it's a big deal.
I refuse to believe that Kaede is the culprit. I still have my doubts. Doubts about the noise, of course. The library should have been quiet, right?
Oh my god.
That shot was rolling through the vents.
Jesus.
It would have made a ton of noise. I refuse to believe that Kaede is the culprit. I still have my doubts.
Kind of doubts.
Doubts about the noise, of course. The library should have been quiet, right?
Yeah, there you go. Jesus fucking Christ. Shit's so finicky.
The murder occurred while the Killing Game promotional video was being broadcast. So the library would not have been completely quiet at the time.
Oh. So that ghastly video drowned out the sound of the shot rolling.
What?
Kaito, are you done now?
Damn it! So it's true then? You're saying Kaede really is the culprit?
So that means most of Kaede's sins were committed right before Shuichi's eyes.
That's correct. I was with her in the classroom. And when she moved the vent grate aside. And when she lined up the books on top of the bookcase.
I did notice that she left the vent case open. That was kind of weird.
And it was the same when you took the murder weapon, wasn't it?
Okay, so... the thing with this is that I can understand that something as complicated would be the answer because DR is stupid and have people with inhuman fucking minds and foresight. But the noticing part is dumb. And no one could figure that this out. I feel like a good game. I'm not calling DRV3 a bad game. I'm saying that I think every case should be, no matter how complicated, like figure outable from the beginning. I don't think anyone could do this. There's probably someone who has, not me, I guess.
You took the shot.
I don't even think someone like Aaron could do this. Coyote? That's dumb. Larvae, that's dumb. Yeah, it would have been a guess.
So you were hiding it the entire time? Where would she have even hidden it?
Her bag, Well, let's see what this says.
I was wrong! Coyote's backpack. She was carrying the shot put ball in there. Despite its weight, it would have been easy to carry in a backpack. I noticed you also had a spare vest, which you could have wrapped it in. That would prevent the cameras you were carrying from being damaged.
And that means all of this happened right in front of Shuichi.
But we should not blame him for that. None of those actions warranted suspicion at the time, so we might not have noticed.
That clears it all up, then. Every part of the crime Kaede plotted.
That can't be. It's gotta be a mistake, right?
But if all of that is true, then that's pretty unfortunate. I mean, it's Kaede, you know? She kept preaching about working together, and then she goes and kills in cold blood!
No, something still doesn't fit.
What doesn't fit?
Coyote wouldn't do something like that.
Huh? You mean she's not the type? But you were the one that said she did it, right?
Yes, I did say that. But murder in cold blood is just not in her character. I truly believe that.
But why? Why do you still believe in me, Shuichi? Why?
Tell me why! Why are you doing this? Are you still looking away from the truth?
Mastermind.
My belief in you.
She wanted to kill the mastermind.
It's gonna lead me to the truth. I'll show you your truth.
No. I don't want to do this one.
Still believe in me? I'm definitely the culprit. You think I wouldn't do it?
definitely the culprit. I'm the one who killed Rantaro. That's the truth of this case. And that's all there is to it. I'm a terrible murderer. I betrayed everyone. I'm the one who
what
killed
the fuck?
Rantaro. That's the truth of this case. Please stop. Just stop. Remember what I told you? You have to fight for the truth. Shuichi, I know you can do this. If you say you believe in me, then... Don't look away from the truth! Please stop! Just stop! Remember what I told you?
This is so dumb.
You have to fight for the truth. Shuichi, I know you can do this. If you say you believe in me, then... Don't look away from the truth! Please stop! Just stop! Remember what I told you? You have to fight for the truth. Do you know what I was trying to do?
I'm so glad that's over already. Oh, that got my fucking heart pumping.
You weren't persuaded by Monokuma. And you weren't trying to save yourself. What you were trying to do was kill the mastermind. Kill the mastermind? Kaede wasn't targeting Rantaro. She was targeting the mastermind. She was trying to end this killing game. She was trying to save us all. Isn't...
I see! Otherwise, everyone would have died when the time limit expired.
So, she tried to end the killing game by killing the mastermind?
But it's all my fault. Kaede trusted my detective skills. I told her the mastermind might be there. And that's why she set that trap. It's all my fault. She trusted my detective work and I screwed it up.
Stop. It's not true. Please. Don't say it's your fault. It'll be harder for me. None of this is your fault. It's mine. Everything's my fault.
Kaede.
Shuichi, can I ask you to do one last favor for me? Can you end all of this?
What?
I want you to reveal everything that happened and convince everyone. And then, I want you to end this. That's my final wish.
I understand. I'll end all of this. I'll reveal everything. The truth and the lies.
Alright, I know what we're gonna do here. What is this? Oh, this is, What? Oh my god. This game is gonna take so long to finish.
Is this?
We can't let it end here.
Oh, Kaido. Come on, dummy. This music's nice, I guess, though.
This is the truth of the case!
It all began 2 days prior, when Monokuma gave us the additional motive. The time limit added to this killing game triggered the crime. After the announcement, some of us decided to form groups to plan our next move. I had my own plan to find a mastermind, and someone offered to help me. At the time, I never would have imagined they would become the culprit. To expose the mastermind, the culprit and I set up hidden cameras in the library. There was a hidden door in the library that showed signs of use. We deduced that the mastermind would return there to let Monokuma out. The next day, we asked Mew if she could modify some cameras for our trap. We then went to the warehouse to gather the necessary materials. All we needed were disposable cameras and a security sensor.
culprit found something else there. The murder weapon. That's right. The shot put ball. They put the cameras, as well as the shot, in their backpack. Then, on the day the time limit would expire, the day of the murder, the culprit and I collected the modified cameras from you and visited the library. Once there, we searched the room for ideal locations to place the cameras. But even then, the culprit was preparing the murder. They began by removing the vent grate and laid it inside the air duct. Then, they moved the pile of books on top of the bookcase, pretending to organize them. After that, they placed open encyclopedias on the final bookcase. It appeared innocuous enough, but it was actually a path for the murder weapon. The culprit also tampered with the hidden camera linked to the security sensor. I was responsible for setting up the other cameras, but that one, I didn't even notice their trick. They used duct tape to keep the flash function on. After the cameras were set, the culprit and I climbed the stairs to the first floor classroom. We kept a lookout for the others and waited for the security sensor to go off. During the stakeout, we saw Kaito and six others go down to the basement. Rantaro was with them, the first victim. After watching that group into the game room, I returned to the classroom. With about 1 hour remaining, the security receiver I was holding went off. I assumed it was the mastermind, so I ran out of the classroom to the library. I was in such a hurry, I left the culprit behind. Looking back on it now, that was the last chance I had to stop the murder. After I had left, the culprit took the shot put ball out of their backpack and rolled it into the classroom vent. This set the murder in motion. Rantaro had moved the bookcase, triggering the receiver. Unbeknownst to him, the trap had been sprung. First, the modified camera took a picture of Rantaro with the flash on. Rantaro noticed the flash and approached the bookcase to inspect the camera. The camera flash lured Rantaro.
I guess the probability of the ball rolling on top of Rantaro's head would be not horribly
the shot the culprit tossed into the vent
impossible due to how fast and heavy the ball was. The ball probably could have fallen fast enough for it to make enough distance to hit his back.
Opening the vent grate and organizing the books was all to create a path. Under normal circumstances, the victim would have been alerted by the noise. But the promotional video was masking the sound of the shot rolling. The shot kept rolling, then fell on Rantaro's head, killing him instantly. By the time
The impact of that doesn't explain the distance. It will be right next to his head.
I imagine seeing Rantaro's body, the culprit probably thought the mastermind is dead. The game is over. Now we can all go home. But their wish didn't come true, because Rantaro wasn't the mastermind.
The ball is way too far.
In an attempt to save all our lives. That is the truth. That's the truth behind your lies, Kaede Akamatsu. The ultimate pianist. And that concludes the events of this case.
I need to back real quick.
Did it?
Damn it!
Shit's so tangled.
It is a truth I do not wish to accept. But since Shuichi has brought everything to light, we can at least try to trust the Kaede we've come to know up to this point.
The Kaede we've come to know?
Even if she did commit a crime, what Kaede has said to us is not a lie. She wanted to protect us. And I firmly believe that to be the truth.
If that was a lie too, it'd be the last straw for me. I'd have nothing left to believe in.
You guys are so nice. Even though I betrayed you.
No, that's not true, Kaede. You were trying to save all of us.
Nice job, Shuichi. I didn't expect any less.
What?
You were super reliable back there. But you still have a long way to go. You need to be more assertive. If you did that more often, you'd be a pretty cool guy.
Kaede, why? Why are you smiling like that? Why are you still trying to get me to be brave? Why, Kaede? Why are you thinking about everyone except yourself? If you had just been less selfless, you wouldn't have had to murder. Why? Why do you do that?
Well, no, if Kaede didn't murder anyone, then... if Kaede didn't murder anyone, then everyone would die.
Termination.
At last, the heart-racing excitement as the blackened and the spotless finally face off.
It's voting time.
Oh.
Chosen as the blackened.
Lol, that'd be pretty funny.
The right choice or the dreadfully wrong one?
That'd be pretty funny. Maybe next time I'll try that. That guy in A, dude, I did awful. Oh my god. I did genuinely terrible.
You really don't get it.
Wait. No.
Right.
I know that. Well then.
Oh yeah.
Sorry.
What?
Okay.
Let's see.
Maybe. But
that's... Sorry.
What?
I see.
Okay.
That's why Shuichi was being quiet during the fucking... I think there was some point when Shuichi was being quiet about the mass... When, Kaede was talking about the mastermind. I guess that's it.
That's wrong! Because... Right?
But...
is a sacred segment. You're not allowed to interfere.
And if you even try to interfere, we'll just crush you with these here exosols.
It's cruel, but it's probably better if one person dies instead of everyone.
Like hell am I just gonna sit here and do what you say? Kaede fought with her life on the line, and so will I.
Gonta will face you all. Times like this are why Gonta became strong. Gentlemen never back down, and neither will Gonta.
This is the perfect chance to test out my knee.
Yeah, I'll help.
Everyone, stop!
Stop it.
Kaede.
I...
Why? Damn it!
No.
Huh?
You know?
I believe in you! You have to live!
It's a promise.
Yeah.
I shall take that request.
Bye.
Well, now. Prepared a very special punishment.
Damn it.
Hey.
You can't lose. It's punishment time. I believe in you.
It's a promise.
Aww. What a first case. This. This is what I thought would happen. Something with piano keys. Really? Aw. Oh, do you mean the in-game audio? Wait, what the fuck? Wait, is this, did this happen for you? Because if that happened for, if that's like a game thing, that's really, really shoddy. That's really dumb. Wait, Monica died? Oh yeah, Monica died. Yay. Didn't even notice. Christ, playing this takes so much out of me. Oh, that was 4 hours. Oh my god.
Nice. Don't screw around.
Is that so?
Too bad.
Damn.
Well.
It's getting interesting!
No.
Hey.
Prayer time!
What?
I don't know.
That's enough! Damn. Shut up!
Damn it. Dumbass.
Huh?
Clench your teeth!
Kaito! You are supposed to say that before you hit him.
Did you hear what Kaede said? She said she believed in you. That she passed her wish onto you. But what the hell's wrong with you? You didn't say a damn thing to Monokuma. You call yourself a man?
Yo, more toxic masculinity by Kaito. I'm about to fucking kill Tenko. I'm so sick of her meme. She's like the Sakura. Not Sakura.
Are you okay?
Okay.
No, Sakura. The one in the first one was Sayaka.
For now.
Listen up. I mean...
I'm gonna split this part up into 2-hour segments. There's no way I can make it just the fucking...
I wish there was a piano here. I would play you a song to help you cheer up. A pretty song to play for you. Oh, like Clair de Lune by Debussy. It's a soothing song that calms your heart, like the moon's reflection on water. You noticed, huh? Yeah, I'm shaking too. But I'd be a mess if you weren't here. I wouldn't have been able to do anything. I would have been so lost. I'm glad you're here with me, Shuichi. With you by my side, I feel like I can stand up to anything. You give me the courage I need to take on the Mastermind. So please, be more confident. I believe in you, so you should definitely believe in yourself.
Yeah, I'll try. I don't know if I can do it, but... No, I'll do it. I have to believe in myself. I won't be afraid anymore. I will face the truth for everyone. I won't give up for your sake, Kaede. I promise. From the bottom of my heart, I promise you, Kaede.
Yep, that's our promise. I'm leaving everything up to you, Shuichi. Goodbye.
That was quite the first chapter, yeah. All right, well, I'll call it there. Oh, I might not do this tomorrow just because that was a lot. Not the, like, in the emotional aspect. I mean, it took 4 fucking hours. Oh my god. That took a really, really long time. Wed. So, bye.